sabai pumsam paro dharma yato bhaktir adhoksaje ahaituki apratihata jaya atma suprasida. So here it is said that it does not matter whether you are a Hindu or Muslim or Christian or Buddhist, it doesn't matter. Your system of religion is first class if you can develop your general love for Krsna or God, Adhoksaja. That is the test. You may advertise yourself, or I may advertise myself, I am a great religious person. But the test is, how much you have learned to love God, how much you have advanced in that process. So here in this verse it is said that sabai pumsam paro dharma yato bhakti adhoksaje. Then what will be my profit? Suppose I simply love God. I love. The loving propensity is there in me. I love some boy, I love some girl, I love my country, I love my family, I love my society, I love my country. The loving propensity is there. There is no doubt. Everyone, even cats and dogs, because he is a living entity, he has got the loving propensity. A tiger also loves its cubs. But this love, when it will be applied to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that is the perfection of love. Sabai pumsam paro dharma yato bhaktir adhoksaje. What kind of love? Ahaituki. To love God not for any other reason. That God will give me some wealth, God will give me this, I shall take from God this. No. Ahaituki. No cause. That because I am in want of some money, therefore, I shall go to church or temple or love God. No, ahuitu. Just like people generally go there, like that. Oh God, give us our daily bread. Well, you are asking God for daily bread. Daily bread is already given to everyone, even birds and beasts. Your bread is also there. But people do not know that my bread is already there. Why I shall bother God for daily bread? Let me learn how to love God. God is giving us so many things without asking. God is giving us light, God is giving us water, God, Bhumir, nalo, vayuh, kham, buddhih, everything is given, without which cannot live. And He will not give us a bread.
Why, he is coming from spiritual friend. He is authorized representative of Krishna. We accept him as Saktavesavada. I was invited in some priestly meeting in Melbourne. They asked me the question, what is your opinion of Christ? So I said, he's our guru. Actually, we accept him. He's preaching God's message. He's Vaishnava. Anyone who accepts God, he was explaining kingdom of God. So according to time, circumstances, audience, we can just imagine what kind of people he had to deal with. That his commandment is, thou shalt not kill. Then understand how much they are accustomed to killing. So what kind of men they were. And not only that, in spite of hearing his instruction, thou shalt not kill, they killed him first. So what kind of men they were, just imagine. He said, thou shalt not kill, and they decided they shall kill you first. So this class of men, he had to deal with.